Welcome everyone to doing a quick look style video at a game I've been looking forward to for a little while, known as Returnal by Housemarque, and published by Sony Interactive Entertainment for PS5. This was announced back during the June event of last year, 2020. What was this? I'll allow that for now. This is my very first time booting up the game. Let's see. This is single player. I'm not gonna have to worry about being invaded or anything, so we'll just leave the online options on for now. Let's go medium for those. All right. So, Returnal is intended to be a challenging experience. Each new cycle presents new challenges, rewards, and changes to the world. Adapt and persevere to progress further. When you die or close Returnal, you'll always be returned to the crash site, and all non-permanent progression will be lost. You can suspend your cycle by using the console's rest mode functionality. So, this is not going to be a full playthrough. It's just going to be looking at for an hour or two, possibly. Returnal is a roguelite. Let's see where we begin here. Pick up on details in a minute. Very first time seeing this cutscene. I don't want to say too much in case they end up repeating the base information about the plot. Seen from previews that damn, this dual sense vibration that they have tied to this game really is something else. You could really feel all the subtle movements in that crash.
Astra, this is Celine. I've crashed on Atropos. I survived, but Helios did not. Suit status operational, but my sidearm is missing. I'm leaving comms open.
Okay, so, our main character here, her name is Selene, and, there's, quite a few subtle, not very subtle things going on right now in regards to naming conventions right off the bat. Main character, Selene, as I stated, her name is, the same name shared by a Greek, moon goddess. Helios is the god who, in his chariot in Greek mythology, took,
abandoning Helios. Heading towards White Shadow Broadcast.
Who, pulled the sun across the sky, every day. And then, finally, this planet is named Atropos, which is the sister of fate who would cut the cloth, but the threads of mortals when their lives were in and you could not place them back together. Atropos was also a boss in God of War 2, along with Lachesis and Clotho. Explore this site a little bit before we go forward. So far, all I can really do is jump button, in addition to moving around. So, this game is a roguelite, which, a lot of people seem to get that confused with roguelike, because those words are very similar, and conceptually they are pretty similar, but the main difference is that a roguelite, such as this, has a form of permanent progression in some way after your death. In games such as this, it's like keeping some of your currency that is used on your character, or certain upgrades, or just small little things like that. While a rogue-like is more true to its namesake, which is an old game, really old game. I believe it's 1980s. It's before my time, but the major deal was that in Rogue, that the character that you created died permanently, and the world changed to be completely different every single time you had died. So, with Rogue likes. Death is permanent, and you keep nothing, and there is no overall progression. It's all within that individual character. With light here being your character that is able to retain something.
This forest contains extensive ruins of a Xenotype civilization. Ancient walls, foundations, and statues.
Really, very, alien-esque imagery. It's like Prometheus, except hopefully not as dumb. Because visually, at least both of these examples look nice. Obelite powers Xenotech devices. Trying to pick up. Data bank entry. Obelite. Previously unknown radioactive mineral, with a crystalline structure and a golden glow. After separating the material from any unknown air, can be auto-gathered by the suit's resource tank. The radiation signatures on the local structures indicate that this has been the primary energy source for the sentient civilization. So it's highly likely that the collected minerals can be used to power dormant xenotype machinery. Additional data needed for further analysis.
Scablog, Atropos. I have found a deceased Astro Scout here. Checking identification on a helmet. It's... Continuing towards the signal's origin.
So, something that I really think is really cool and really interesting about this is that, being a roguelite, this game is procedurally generated, and that's tying into the story much how every death our main character here is going to be sent back to the ship. We're going to see how many times I die and have to do that tonight, but and the world resets around her after that, and I find it a fantastic detail to see your dead body of yourself already here, meaning that you're getting into this plot not right at the beginning, because who knows how long this has been going on for our main character here. Suit computer. So far it's just been a hallway. Undiscovered item. Preliminary analysis. Safety approach. Potentially beneficial. Oh. Sylphion.
Discovered a potential resource. Positive analysis for suit repairs. Classifying as Sylphion.
Repairs moderate damage to integrity. Nice and destructible. Anything inside? Nope. Oh, circles to dash. Neat. I noticed that there's a little sort of meter at the bottom for a cooldown. Locked gate, a xenotech gate, secured with a lock mechanism, requires a key. Again, really cool visuals. Unlimited ammunition, as one would expect, though it does have to reload. Glad it does so automatically.
Fauna dispatched. Recorded log found. Adding to databank. Scout log. Atropos. Elapsed time, 30 minutes since last crash. Whole areas of this forest are rearranging themselves like a fluid puzzle after each of my... Whenever I return, per Astra protocol, I will not be recovered until I reach the broadcast signal. If you're hearing this, you are stuck here too. Playing back now. Scout log. Atropos.
Oops.
Elapsed time. 30 minutes since last crash. Whole areas of this forest are rearranging themselves like
a
fluid puzzle after each of my... Whenever I return, per Astra protocol, I will not be recovered until I reach the broadcast signal. If you're hearing this, you are stuck here too. I don't remember recording that.
One of the, should I say, bigger roguelites on the market right now that I'm also fond of is Hades by Supergiant Games. Its justification for story-wise is that you're the son of the Greek god Hades, which since it seems both of these are drawing on Greek mythology and in very different ways, I think that's a pretty neat little, like, overlap there, though I'm 100% sure that it was not intended. This has probably been in development for a few years, and just things happen to work out in parallel, kind of like God of War 2018 and Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. A xenotype technology consisting of a triangular metallic wedge with a hologram sphere. Code with data similar to access code. Energy signature indicates that it's used to open locked gates and containers. Despite the sturdiness of the materials, the object is programmed to parsing error itself upon use for some unknown reason. Additional data needed for further analysis. I'm loving the visual style of this already. I mean, look how cool this is. Circle a dash, hold circle for a longer dash. Use dash while in midair to perform long jumps. While dashing, you are invulnerable to hazards and most enemy attacks. Cool. That's what I figured it had to be. Sophium resin. Fills one slot towards max integrity upgrade. Huh. A silphium that has undergone unknown reference, the resin form seems to be the end result of a sudden explosive excretion of sap-like substance from the fruiting body. This sap hardens fast when exposed to air, creating crystalline structures. This hardened substance is still malleable and exceedingly suitable for improving the suit's max integrity. What causes a specimen to undergo this transformation is so far unknown. Additional data needed, blah blah blah.
Security system encountered.
Well, I'm not gonna try to dash through that. I have a feeling that will hurt. Gates and containers best infected with no agency. Oh! We've got an enemy over there. Okay, now I hope they're all gone. Malfunctions or negative effects gained from malignant items or parasites. Remove a malfunction by completing the task on the left side of the screen. Okay, wall in midair, 50% webby damage. Collect artifacts, okay. So that's how I get rid of the little malfunction there. Oh, I'm sure that's friendly.
That broadcasts the white shadow signal. Shot and just comes right back. Reminds me of Annihilation. Nice, a screaming. That just makes me think of Shadow of the Colossus.
Encountered hostile failure.
may be my first death here. Yep. There we go. Really cool late title card. Very appropriate spot for it, too.
Helios! Astra, this is Selene. I survived the... Can you hear me? I'm in my ship. Suit status operational and... I've already experienced this before.
Helios has two terminals. Use the main terminal and the challenge terminal. The main terminal can be used to view your overall statistics and ship logs information. The challenges terminal can be used to access the daily challenge, where you compete against other scouts once it is unlocked. That's pretty cool. It's a whole big old stat screen. This game has multiple first-person segments when it comes to advancing the story, apparently. And I did not know that you also go first-person in your ship here. That's cool. Tentacle monsters, things of the deep ocean there. Are we sure this isn't Bloodborne? Out we go. I don't have to go back through all that exactly again. Every time you die, you return to the crash site without the weapons, artifacts, and resources collected in the last cycle.
The environment wasn't like this before.
So, I noticed that adrenaline meter that you get from killing enemies. It seems like the more you kill and the less you get hurt, the... The more buffs you start to get. Like, I just lost some of that adrenaline. Because I just, fell in that water. I was not sure if I could swim, and well, that answers that question. So far, destroying stuff has netted me nothing, but I'm going to keep doing it. Maybe the stone stuff doesn't do anything so far. This looks organic. Oh, ah. Malignant resin, or malignant, yeah, fills one slot towards max integrity upgrade, but is infected with malignancy. spoiled resin, a resin that has become infected with a mold-like disease, making it potentially harmful for use in improving Mac's integrity. Seems likely that the infection has set in before the fungus assumed the resin form. But it is interesting that this does not cause the infection to recede or halt. The nature of the infection seems to be one where it is able to devour the database mismatch itself. Resin that has become contaminated by unknown air, causing it to glow purple and emit unknown residence aerosol. While this phenomenon known as malignancy is not directly obscuring the primary user specimen, it can cause malfunction in the systems and so far unknown means, as there is no difference between a healthy and a malignant specimen, despite the clear visual difference between the two. Alright, maybe I'll slow down reading all this stuff. Okay, so... okay, so I'm getting multiple malfunctions here. Fab care cost increased by 25. Suffer damage when using keys. Fabricate items to remove the first one, and use consumables to remove the second. A xenotech device for recycling materials, output unknown. Warning, interaction can damage integrity. Kind of afraid to do this, but don't know if you don't try. Okay, yeah, that did hurt me. Gain 5% weapon damage per adrenaline level. Artifacts or beneficial effects, some have passive, but some have activation conditions. View them in the equipment tab. Oh, some health up there. Oh, and I think the meter that I thought was dashing was actually my adrenaline, so... not sure the visual indicator for the dashing, if there is one.
New technology discovered. Augments my weapon with an alternative firing mechanism.
L2, press halfway down to focus aim. Oh, hold L2.
Highly effective. This will be useful.
Yeah, no kidding. Seems it needs a target. Okay, so it needs to recharge. That's big. Interesting. And it takes a minute. Got it. Okay. adrenaline sets when you get hit. Some help. Broken Calibre grabs a small amount of weapon proficiency. Damage siphon and data cube. Deposit into a matching device to permanently unlock this item designed for future cycles. You can only carry one at a time. Okay. Wonder where I put that. Actually gonna look at the database for that. Back at the crash site, he wants me to put that. I wonder if this heals me, just to test. Probably not. I have a feeling it's not that generous. Cool dreams though. Oh, it did. Cool. Is everything reset? Nope. Okay. Good to know. Permanent resource ether that interacts with other timelines and cleanses malignancy. Okay, sounds cool. Ether's mysterious resource that's kept on death. Gain ether by interacting with deceased scouts and completing daily challenges in the ship. You also use your ether to cleanse malignant items. Yes. use the key. Obelite stabilizer. Drop obelite lasts 3 times longer. I wish I knew how to fabricate items. Oh, that's cool. It's a little creature. I assume if you get to the top, it tries to kill you. But so it's basically a lethal elevator if you're sleeping on it. Doesn't seem to go anywhere, so I'm not gonna take it. Can't seem to kill it either. Better have dash when you get in there. Obelite chunk. Contains large amount of obelite. Xenotech required. They blend in so well. No idea what that is. Press forward, I suppose.
A xenotype weapon, similar to our carbine technology.
Unlock new weapon traits and stats with proficiency. Gain proficiency by eliminating hostiles. Okay, so the alt fire remains, but the main fire changes. That's cool. I like this. These ones don't go away. I like that little overheating animation.
Discovered a massive wall beyond which is the white shadow signal. I can't cross the chasm. For now, I'll change objectives and investigate the energy reading in the forest. Scout log, Atropos. Who triggered the broadcast? Do you see the white shadow is something only I should know? And now, out of literally nowhere, I'm hearing it again. Were the sentients involved? But how would they have known? I need to believe there are answers at the signal.
I flash red from getting the adrenaline, I swear I'm taking damage. And it's the opposite.
Xenotype device acquired. I think this will prove a useful tool.
Cool. Again, Armalite chunk contains large amount of obelites but is infected. Xenotech required, needs 4 ether to cleanse. Okay. Shield disruptor data cube. Deposit into matching device to permanently unlock this item. Still have no idea where. Nope. Okay, so I can only hold one at a time. Take the damage siphon one, I guess. It sounds like either like a vampiric ability or something that is like a sort of a shield for me. The other one sounds like something to help get rid of shields on enemies. Now you see why I like to play offline. And also, that sounds like an enormous existential crisis.
one of the worst.
Proficiency measures your combat ability per cycle. You get proficiency from each hostile you dispatch. But there are also items that grant you proficiency or affect your proficiency rate, i.e. how much proficiency you gain from dispatching hostiles and items. Your proficiency determines the minimum level of weapons you find in the world. So, I'm seeing that as the random drops you're getting on weapons, the higher proficiency, the more powerful ones you can get. Okay, that's a neat little system. Unfortunately. Okay. Gotta go in a loop. Fitting. Damage Fabricator. Damage Xenotech device. Fabricates a random item in your exchange for increasing amount of obelites. Interference Sphere. Disables all turrets within area. Used up the other one I have. Because why not? Don't know if that counts as a turret, but I'm not gonna waste it. tech device required.
Discovered xenotype technology on the corpse of a sentient. Scan is indicating potential for suit augmentation. Appears safe to repurpose. System integration complete. Performing a function test to confirm.
So what does that do? Can now use translocators to teleport. So that's what that is. Okay. We'll explore first. More in here. Oh, that's cool.
Confirmed. Point to point teleportation. Location exit seems fixed.
See a way of reaching that. Give it one more shot, but yeah, no. I do not have a dash. Where does this want me to go? Okay, now I can use that. This one's new. Oh, okay. That's nice. That's all cool.
Discovered xenotype technology that produces other devices.
Obelite repository. Exchange ether and obelites for one another. It seems poised to do something if enough obelites are placed in it. Cooperation with their scouts is encouraged. it's an online thing. Okay, it wants me to interact with the middle one. Got it. Interference spear, adrenaline leech. Alt fire protection. Enhanced calibrator. Okay, I have 323. This one sounds really cool. And I can't, I don't have way more, so... Oh. Wow. Increases max integrity by 25%. And I'm out of opalites because I just spent most all of them. Oh. Let's see. Okay, so that just seems like it's passively equipped already.
Evidence of rudimentary xenotype language discovered. Currently lacking resources to decipher this xenoglyph.
Ah, so this is a big fast travel thing. Won't use that quite yet.
Discovered a fragment of the xenotype language.
Guess I have to get enough of those in order to translate it.
Detecting a strange energy reading. Setting a marker on my map.
Okay, so... Curious where I get more, weapons. How do those start dropping? Thank you. Okay.
Small life form. Seems docile.
Started when alien vice
it's
did work.
Parasitically
it.
Attached to my arm. Does not appear hostile. Somehow, it's strengthening and weakening my suit.
Parasites have both beneficial and detrimental effects to your suit. Press your status screen to learn more about attached parasites. Find salvage from hostiles more often. Upcoming malfunctions have more severe effects. Okay.
Hear me. I'm alone. The environment is changing. Could the force be adapting?
Okay. Kept that off fire. Just for this weapon. Okay. I think I misunderstood. For some reason I thought they were the same. They were just simple. One of those first two weapons. My ass kicked a little, but I'm liking this. Oh. As noted, when I'm not paying enough attention to all the enemies being dead. Or not. Okay. I dig this. Fire augment, protection augment, I do not have enough for either of these. And I keep my little teleporter thing when I die. So that's permanent. That's cool. And of course that's gonna change what is going to be CPU generated. Very cool. Okay. Did I actually grab that key? Okay, yes I did. Oh, oh. Damn it. Alright, I'm heading back to the ship to heal that. Sorry. Okay. Now that I've looked, on the lower left, next to that, health meter and stuff, I see the dash cooldown and the alt-fire cooldown as well. I appreciate all these weird little dreams that they've given her for going to sleep. Alright, let's try not to fall in the rain step. Hollow Seeker. Okay. So it's like a rapid fire thing? Like some sort of assault gun? Kind of a spread on it, and then alt fire. Oh, that's cool. I like that. Beats the default pistol, so I'll take it.
Enough. I understand. I'm trapped. broadcast signal. That's all that matters. Astra, Helios is gone. Celine heading out.
I'm thinking maybe one or two more runs before I call it for the night. Again, I feel like I'm getting kicked, but I'm enjoying it. Which is weird. But I mean, not in like a Souls way, but a completely different feeling. I don't play a whole lot of roguelike things. So this is very refreshing to me. Don't know how many of these I want to pick up. Let's do one more. Oh boy. Well, does this count? Okay. Oh jeez. While stationary, 75% weapon damage. Well, I better move then when I'm... Parasite's Allegiance was the 50% melee damage, and I don't even have a melee weapon, so I'll take that. It's supposed to auto repair my suit at a certain health threshold. Ooh. Oh, jeez. What am I supposed to do there? My ult fire changed again. I'm not entirely sure what's causing it anymore. That guy has a shield that I can't get rid of. I don't think so. Nope, my bolts just bounced right off. This is increased integrity, so see if this upgrades my health. Ooh, that looks cool. Very ominous. Parasite's healing me. a little bit, up to 30%. Where else did that take me? Nowhere. Okay. What the hell were those? Thought they were enemies. Electropylon driver. Let's see what this is. Oh, huh. Oh, okay. Fires back to that. So I'm guessing this, that the alt fire is going to be random on every weapon. Electro conduits that attack enemies and they have to be between them or around them. Very cool. Shoot it and they attach it to them. That's very cool. I like that. Great. Overload disabled. Don't remember what overload was, or if I've even unlocked it yet, so... Okay. That's a really good parasite. Fix the problem, and it just goes away. Man, this is a cool weapon idea. I love it. Just wish I could break those shields. That's what I get for thinking I could make it. Okay, so this part seems to be set a little bit, rather than completely random. Just a little. I love that thing's design, it's so cool. And thankfully, it dropped the better version of what I'm already carrying, so awesome. Huh. Xenotech device bracket reconstruction of complex entities per environment. So well, too. Not worth it. Lost my other one, so I might as well take that. Darn. I was hoping to get the other one too.
That can't be here. Feeling like I was losing my mind.
comfort here. No safe space. And the astronaut keeps following me.
Darn, I was hoping to get in. Because I know from one of the trailers a while ago that you, when you go inside those, there's a, they're like first person, more horror segments. Kind of. Not totally, but they have that vibe. Okay. What do we got here? Fire, not ready yet. Okay, it's a tracker swarm. Got it. It's a 5% weapon damage for every 200 obelites carried. Maximum bonus 20%. I must be having internet troubles. That LAN thing. Let's see here. I appreciate that the parts of the map that you haven't been to, the doors are color-coded. Serious, especially the way my controller is vibrating. I don't want to fall in that, it'll probably hurt. entirely sure what's the next direction. Guess it's this one. Okay, yeah, I haven't been here. Thing die? I don't see it, but I don't trust that it did. I thought it teleported.
My house key. How could this be here?
All right then, back to the house. That looks like a boss door. And the house is... where it is? Over there. This animation on Twitter, it's really cool. And I bet that's quite a feeling.
Exactly as I left it. But impossible.
Gouge it out. You just can't trust the tap water.
This was taken after I left. Why? I logged my first missions in this binder. But this is stored in the mothership's archives.
Alright, you're probably wondering what happened. So the last 20-25 minutes or so of my video got corrupted. I managed to beat that boss on the first try. However, it's not really all is lost. After you beat him, you get the item known as the Crimson Key in order to open this here up and proceed to the next biome as so. Can't go backwards after that unless you decide to go ahead and completely restart your run again. I just wanted to show off this entrance to this new biome before heading off. When we arrive here, in the Crimson Waste, Selene mentions heading towards that strange energy signature, like the previous boss. And it's not the game's fault that my computer did not save the last 25 minutes of that video correctly. I have no idea exactly what caused that to happen. It hasn't happened before. And well, it hopefully won't happen again. But I just decided to go ahead and record this new outro explaining what happened. The game's still really fun, and I greatly appreciate it. It's super cool. I'm definitely still learning a fair bit of the ropes when it comes to dodging and the bullet hell mechanics. But I figured out some other things since then, but notably the overload mechanic. That large bar in the middle of your reloading animation in the reticle, what actually it is that when you run out of ammo and hit R2 again while the meter is flowing through that, it will reload automatically instead of forcing you to wait the entire time for it to reload normally. Just thought I'd explain that right before I go. A little bit of a weird non sequitur there, but this place looks cool. I'm looking forward to exploring it and playing more of the game in general. And with all that in mind, thank you very much for joining me, and I'll catch you later. Bye.